The following podcast is brought to you by the folks at GoodPoliticsRadio.com.
Fred Gedrich is with us, former U.S. State Department guy. He also survived Hurricane Agnes in 1972. Fred, how are you?
Chuck, delighted to be with you today.
Fred, I got to tell you, I've done a number of broadcasts the last couple of weeks. And, of course, everybody knows about Hurricane Katrina, and every day another domino falls. Now, one of the latest dominoes is, what are they going to do about all of the illegal immigrant employees in the Gulf Coast area who are now also evacuees?
Boy, that's an interesting question, and it'll be very interesting to see what they really do with them. I'm sure there are quite a few illegals in and around that area, and I'm sure the federal government and also the state and local governments will probably think first of saving lives, and then I think gradually we'll see things fall into place. But certainly that's going to be an interesting issue.
Well, Fred, respectfully, I don't think our government has the stomach to do the right thing. You know, in my opinion, I think it is very fitting that George Bush Sr. and Bill Clinton are passing the hat for the permanent underclass that has been created that now is very visible from the New Orleans area. Because it was those two gentlemen that bankrupted the United States. George Bush Sr. Made sure that all the alternative energy programs were shut down when he got to be VP with Reagan. After that, he was the champion of NAFTA and GATT. And then, of course, Bill Clinton made sure that it got passed through Congress any way it had to be done. And so Bush Sr. and Clinton pretty much bankrupted the United States. And even people like Peter G. Peterson of the CFR and former Secretary Treasurer, you know, will admit it in an oblique way. They won't come right out and say who done it, but they'll say the policies have failed or something like that. But the worry that I've got is what Peter G. Peterson said last Friday. And he said, the entire net worth of the United States of America is $40 trillion. $40 trillion. That's the entire net worth. That's your house, my house, everything. And it won't be long that it will totally be owned by foreigners at the rate we're going with our trade deficit and federal deficit. What do you think of that?
Yep. I don't disagree with your views on this. I think it's a serious problem, and hopefully we can educate the public as to what is really going on. And and unless we protect our borders, make sure that immigration is only open to those who are processed legally, we're going to have problems for the foreseeable future.
But is there anybody in Washington, D.C. that gets it? I mean, obviously Clinton didn't get it. Bush Jr., he don't get it.
Well, the unfortunate thing, and when I go over town, attend some of the meetings, and hear the various discussions on this topic whenever they come up, what's obvious to anyone who has an objective outlook on this matter is that neither side, this is Republicans, Democrats, are willing to sacrifice their political advantage for doing what is the right thing. And the Republicans don't want to open the door to the Democrats for what happened back in California in the early 90s when they took a tough stand on illegal immigrants. What happened was that, in effect, put the Democrats in power in California for a decade. And I think you see some posturing on the parts of governors in Arizona and New Mexico. Mexico that the Governor Napolitano and Richardson, who are Democrats, and they're professing to be taking a harder line, declaring emergencies on the matter. But whether they're really sincere and willing to do what needs to be done, and that's to really tighten up the border and prosecute those people who are aiding the illegal immigrants while they're in the country. And let's face it, there's a big black market out there in human bodies, and there's a lot of people who are making dollars out of paying illegal immigrants in minimal wages, and you see it all over the country. All you have to do up in our neck of the woods is right by in any one of the cities in Northern Virginia, the 7-Elevens, and you see the daily laborers. Now, I would bet more than half of them are illegals. And yet what they do is offer services, and they come around, and people close their eyes, and they don't want to deal with the problem. Now, some of these people are not only illegals, some of them are criminals. and even more scary are, with our open borders, are the possibility that terrorists are coming across and really, you know, up to no good and meaning us harm. So we have to do something about the problem. It's unfortunate that neither the Republican or Democratic Party has the political will to deal with the problem today.
There are two things. If God forbid, I lose my health insurance. If God forbid, I lose my health insurance. And I have an unexpected hospitalization. And I get back home and the bills start arrive, and they're $50,000, $60,000, $70,000, which they would be. By the way, a friend of mine was in the hospital for 4 hours to have a tube changed from his kidney to his drainage system. 4 hours he was in the hospital. The bill was $25,000. 4 hours. Now, I had an incident the other day where I went into an outpatient clinic at a hospital for a blood test, and I found out that they have three different price schedules for each service that they offer. Had I been taken in by an ambulance as an uninsured, taxpaying American, the blood test would have been $1,497. Had I paid cash in advance, they wanted $970. But because I had a Blue Cross Blue Shield card, it was $116. And I paid in advance. Then they tried to send me an additional bill for $108, and I was able to get that canceled, only probably because of the fact I do a radio show. But the bottom line is this. If you are a honest, tax-paying American citizen, and God forbid you don't have health insurance, and you have an unexpected hospitalization, you and your family are now bankrupt. And with George Bush's new little bankruptcy law that he and his banker friends got through Congress, you then will become an indentured servant for 5 years. Now, if you are, however, an illegal immigrant, and you are taken to that same hospital in that same ambulance, you nor your family will pay a dime. Not one dime. You will be totally covered by state and federal government agencies. Now, at some point in time, Mr. and Mrs. America are going to wake up, and it'll be after October 17th of this year when the impact of this new bankruptcy law starts hitting millions and millions and millions of American families. And then and only then will they say, we have been sold out. Hang on. Let me do a two-minute breather, and then I'll get your complete response and hand you the microphone and listen. Fred Gedrich is with us, Chuck Harder, for the people on TalkStar.
Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom, one of the best shows television ever offered. Now you can travel again with Marlon Perkins to the farthest reaches of the globe and study wild animals in their natural habitats. the Emmy Award-winning Wild Kingdom, now available on DVD. Order online at RetroTelevision.com and get 20 full-length episodes for $29.99. You'll see gorillas, elephants, giraffes, zebras, hippos, and more. Also memorable, three episodes featuring legendary primate researcher Diana Fossey from Gorillas in the Mist. 20 episodes of Wild Kingdom on DVD for $29.99. Go to RetroTelevision.com, or if you forget, log on to www.talkstarradio.com and check out our video store. Save $10 on Wild Kingdom now at RetroTelevision.com.
If you've got kids, chances are sooner or later you're going to need dental help. And when you do, I hope you'll remember 1995dental.com. 1995dental.com tells you how to save about 50% on braces for your kids, similar savings on other services. Because this isn't insurance, there is no waiting period, no exclusion, no claim forms to fill out. You get instant savings from tens of thousands of dentists coast to coast. Unlike a lot of insurance policies, this discount program covers cosmetic dentistry, bonding, and cleaning. For the individual, it's $11.95 a month, but for the entire family, everyone who lives under your roof, regardless of age or relationship, it's $19.95 a month. Hence our name, 1995dental.com. Type in the numbers 1995, then the word dental.com. 1995dental.com will save you.
Fred Gedrich, let me hand you the microphone and your thoughts.
Well, the first thing that crossed my mind is I'm sure all your listeners have had experiences throughout their lives going to an emergency section of the hospital. And unless your wounds or injuries or malady is life-threatening, what will happen is you'll sit in, particularly in areas where there are a lot of immigrants, in a waiting room for literally hours upon hours, and it's quite an experience. But when you think of what goes on in the hospital and the cost that's being passed on through the hospital to Americans that are here illegally, it's really astounding. And you're correct, the different prices for the different types of coverages one might have, and it's just a terrible problem. Now, if you look at it from a global perspective, the world has 6.2 billion people, and there's a lot of anti-American sentiment around the globe, but in my travels, I would, and I think any objective person would also support what I have to say on this, is most of the people of the world would immigrate to the United States in a nanosecond. Just so happens we have a porous border on the south where immigrants are coming across in such great numbers that our local economy and infrastructure can barely support them. Now, unless we plug those holes, we're going to have nothing but problems in the foreseeable future. Now, the other thing we got to be worried about is what impact is that going to have on our system of governance? Because there are some politicians who want to grant illegal immigrants driver's license with the photo, and that is what is used at a lot of places around the country to register to vote. And so we have a situation where people who are not even citizens of this country may be influencing our elections and having a say in what our policy are going to be on regarding border control and a whole plethora of other issues.
Well, that's how Bill Clinton got reelected. Ask Dick Morris or Mr. Shippers. But the bottom line is that it is a problem that, if we don't get a handle on it, this country will turn into a third world country. And we're getting very close to that. What what very few people in the United States know is that the elite people, the people who really are super rich, have a couple of different places in the United States where there is typically one road in, and the road is monitored, and they have secured communities. There's a place in the Carolinas where there's only one road in to this particular area, and all the communities are secured. And if you're on that road going into that area, you will be stopped. And if they believe you have no business there, you will be turned around. There are some places out west similar to this. And so, in other words, the super elite already have their escape hatch places to run to when this country turns into a cesspool, or at least, pardon the expression, they think they do.
Right. You don't have to look any further than Ted Turner, the CNN mogul, and he has that big ranch, I believe it's up in Montana. That's his sanctuary. And yet he has the global agenda, and he's trying to ram all this one-world-style government down our throat, if he had his way. And they don't live in the same world we live in, and you got to be careful of what the elitists are saying. Unfortunately, they have controls of the mainstream news media. Fortunately for the average person, we have outlets like your show and plenty of others on talk radio and the Fox News Network. At least we're getting a little more balance in what we're receiving over the airways.
I was rather amazed that Fox News sort of turned, you know, they've been very, very pro-Bush and pro-Republicans. When Shepard Smith was in New Orleans and no help came day after day after day, he finally blew his top, and I was kind of surprised about that. I thought that was I didn't expect that of Fox to even air the fact that they would be critical of our present administration, because normally they're not, you know.
Well, I think if you look at all the shows, you have a situation where it's probably the most balanced network of all those on TV, cable, and the mainstream networks. And you got Geraldo, who was also critical of the Bush administration. And Greta is, if anything, a liberal. And so you have a little bit of balance and a lot more, in fact, than you see elsewhere. Now, I think the situation we saw unfold in New Orleans would cause any sane person to really lose their cool, because when you see human suffering and the wheels of government gridlock like they were, it's really a scary proposition. But if you look at it, how the local government, the mayor in particular, failed to implement their emergency preparedness plan. You look at the governor, she was so tentative, and she would not turn over the National Guard. The National Guard belongs to the state and to the federal government, and so she delayed it. And then the president himself, I was looking at an editorial or a piece written by former New York Mayor Ed Koch today, and he was critical of the local state officials, but he blamed Bush and Bush too.
Hang on, we'll be right back in just 2 minutes.
You know what Shakespeare said to do with all the lawyers? Well, okay, that might be tempting, but a better idea might be to survive the lawyers. When you need a do-it-yourself legal form of any kind, and we're talking about over 10,000 different kinds of legal forms here, go to www.chuckpartnershow.com. Right there on the homepage, you'll find the link for over 10,000 legal forms. These forms are designed to help protect your rights and save you time and money. Why pay more elsewhere for the same type of legal forms? Here are over 10,000 forms prepared by attorneys and offered with a no-risk, 100% money-back guarantee. So when you need legal forms of any kind, go to www.chuckhardershow.com. That's CHUCKHARDERSHOW.com. There's no cost to check it out. Go to www.chuckhardershow.com, where you can link up with over 10,000 legal forms online.
Is the burden of large credit card debt getting too heavy for you to carry alone? Call Debt Relief of America. They are expert debt negotiators that go to work for you to eliminate 50 to 60% of your credit card debt.
Within 3 months, I was debt-free and the collection hassle stopped.
I was buried in debt with no way of knowing how I was going to get out. DRA worked with my creditors and cut my debt in half.
My wife and I both feel Debt Relief of America is a godsend.
Call now for your free debt relief consultation. There is absolutely no cost or obligation. You will get a step-by-step plan on how Debt Relief of America can help you wipe out up to 60% of your credit card bills. Call 800-509-5495. 800-509-5495. One call could literally save you thousands of dollars. Not available in all states. 800-509-5495. 800-509-5495.
Fred Gedrich is with me. Fred, I just one quick thing I wanted to mention. A guy who is kind of a hero of mine, his name is David Orrick. He runs Orrick Corporation. They make vacuum cleaners and such as that. I don't even know if his factory is there anymore. They were at 100 Plantation Road in New Orleans.
Mm-hmm.
And on their website, they say they're trying to find their employees first, but obviously they're out of business. But here was a guy who kept his factory in the United States, pulled every trick in the book he could to hire Americans, and his factory had to be hit by Katrina. Just what a shame.
Oh, it's heartbreaking when you see the individual stories like that. And there are a lot of heroes, too, that we don't read about. I think what sickened me more as much as the natural disaster we saw is the behavior of some political types who, seeking political advantage, start blaming everybody. I think the first order of business is certainly there'll be time to assess what really went wrong and place blame where it belongs when it's all said and done. But when people are struggling for their lives, they need food and medicine. I thought it was a time for all Americans to rally together instead of, you know, at least for a couple of days, stop the partisan bickering.
Yeah.
And get in there and help those 300,000 people get out of the city. Now, a lot of them didn't want to leave. And what do you do in a situation like that? Do you force them?
Well, all that's water under the bridge because they didn't expect what to happen to happen. And by the end of today, there won't be very few. There'll be just a few people left in New Orleans. And then, of course, the water is toxic. They've already had people die from exposure to the water in the streets in New Orleans. So the bottom line is this is all going to play out. But the concern I have is for the United States of America. You know, long story short, a couple of years ago I filed a Freedom of Information Act request with the Department of Commerce and the Department of Labor. And I asked him, I said, in the last 20 years, how many factories have been sent offshore, bought offshore, transferred offshore, and how many have closed? Can you please tell me? Would you like to know the response I got back from both agencies?
What was it?
Sorry, but that information is classified.
Holy cow. Well, what troubled me about New Orleans is when you scan the world news, and you see groups like the BBC showing bodies floating in the water. Now, up in Hurricane Agnes back in 72 in Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania, we had an unfortunate situation at the one of the bends in the Susquehanna River. It disinterred a whole lot of bodies from a cemetery. And as you know, down in New Orleans, the bodies are buried above ground.
We got about 20 seconds. Use it wisely.
Yeah, and what we found up in Wilkes-Barre was disinterred bodies and mannequins floating, and I think we're going to find out that a lot of the casualties are corpses. from that had been placed in vaults and also mannequins, and yet there's probably going to be a substantial loss of life, and that's going to be very tragic. And I think our enemies around the globe are going to try to highlight that, just to, you know, belittle us and saying we're insensitive to our own people. And
Fred, thanks for being with us. We'll talk again. You're a good guy.
Pleasure, as usual.
I want to thank you for a great half hour. Ladies and gentlemen, you know where all of the help sources are by now, so please do what you can. And to our troops in harm's way, God bless you. To you and yours and your loved ones, wherever you might be, I wish you well and I pray for you. If we don't do something for America, who will? If we don't do it now, when? I don't know what else to say other than I thank you for allowing this broadcast to come into your radio. I love my nation, and I love what's left of it. I'd like to see everything improve for everybody. God bless America.
The views expressed on this podcast do not necessarily represent the views of the folks at GoodPoliticsRadio.com. We welcome your comments about this podcast and would like to hear from you. For Good Politics Radio, this is Don Llewellyn. Thanks for listening.